Hello and welcome everyone. So in the previous videos, we have created some of the basic task APIs like get task by ID, create task and all. So we will just go through the basics. Like here we were getting get all task, and from the task store service, we were returning all the task. Okay. So we can also test these basic functionalities. Like here we were creating some task. We can create a number of tasks and then we can get all these tasks, and you can also do task by ID. You just need to pass this task HTTP get and you can see this particular task, right? Now we can also add other methods like delete. In the same task controller, you can have a delete by ID. We have the validation pipes, and here you can see the delete task. We are passing the ID. And this delete task is doing nothing, but it's filtering out the data except that particular ID record, and the remaining record we are returning. Okay, very basic things. Now let's try to improvise this and let's see how we can actually throw a particular exception once the ID is not found when you are trying to get. Consider this particular situation here. If we are trying to say task is there and task is there and task.length is greater than 0, then it's fine. We can just return this. What if we don't have a task? Then we are okay to throw some exception. Throw new not found exception. Okay, we can say task not found. Right, so this exception will go to the task controller because task controller is doing get task by ID. That same will pass to this. Right, now in task controller, are we handling this, and we'll try to see how it will react when we are trying to pass an invalid task ID. Okay, let's see in the postman how this will work, what kind of response code and things we are getting. So we can try this here. Data I already lost, but you can see task not found. Why we are getting it? Because exception is being thrown here. So it is actually throwing the exception directly to the controller. We can also try to handle these kind of exceptions. Like we can just try to put try catch, or you can just avoid it because NextJS is already handling these exceptions at controller level. If you're not even handling them, here you can just throw error, right? So it's the same thing. I didn't do any change. Whatever the exception we are getting from the service, we are throwing back again. Here you can just do a logging if you want this dot logger. Okay, this is a particular error we got, or you wanted to try to just change it to an internal server exception and just try to convert it to 500 with the message and all the things are same. You can also do this, but in that case you will end up here having 500 error code instead of 404. So try to throw the same exception which you are getting from service to the controller. You don't need to even handle it in the try catch. If you are handling it better in the services, then don't need to do a try catch in the controllers. Now you can see we are getting task not found here. The status code, this status code is here. The HTTP status code you are getting is 500. Don't look at the internal message, these are the status code. But for API client, this is 500 status code, right? So this is what happens when you try to override the error codes. You can just throw HTTP exception. This is generic exception, and you can just say HTTP exception takes two argument, response and the status. Error dot message HTTP code dot, you can say internal server. HTTP status, HTTP code is okay. Why it's not auto populating things? HTTP status dot here you can say internal server error, right? So this is also you can throw, but what is the better way, right? Here we are actually just creating a wrapper, express wrapper. But can we get rid of this? Yes, we can. We can just simply return this and we can get rid of old code. What we are doing is whatever we are getting from the get task, get store, we are just returning that. Okay, same, we can just try to run and let's see what we will get. So if you are passing a wrong ID, then we should be getting 404. You can see 404. So whatever we are getting from the service, we are returning back to the controller, and controller will throw the not found exception, which will be handled by NestJS, right? Because this is a predefined exception we are throwing, not found exception, bad request exception, internal server exception and all. Okay, so in the next video, we'll try to just create a interceptor to handle these exceptions.